I got you.
Now, the same thing backwards.
I got sex, I got uniform, I got power, I got images. Yes, I got out to the door.
So can anybody tell which were the front words I got? So like half of them are front words either way, and the other half are backwards, which just sounds like I got either way. Yeah. Weird things. Anything else that we missed that we should...
Was some of the original record backwards? Hmm? Was some of the recordings on the original Burroughs record backwards?
No, they're just, it was just him talking on the record backwards, but I listened to the whole record backwards and I discovered that there were these things there. That it's not just Burroughs saying that. I tried recording a little pile of people and it tends to be, I got is an acoustic palindrome. You ever need an acoustic palindrome for something? It's one of the few.
Are you going to play the Barrys?
Sure. Is everybody hearing the question about referencing things in the world and the idea of starting from scratch? I just recently discovered a quote from, remember the butt-headed astronomer, Carl Sagan? He was unfortunately demised, or whatever the word is for being dead. He said, if you want to start something from scratch, you create a universe and go from there. So you're always... starting off with something. Some people start off with a piano that somebody else invented, and so in a way they're appropriating this other person's musical invention, being the piano. I tend to disagree with people all the time. It's a bad habit of mine. So I was immediately disagreeing with when you said your practice seems to be about referencing things. I would say probably in relation to these things, my practice is... manipulating time and our perception of time. And perception is much more interesting to me than referencing things. And it might get back to the comment that we were trading back and forth near the beginning where I was talking about how it's just so much easier to present serial music if it sounds like the Beatles. These guys in Paris had this great thing. They were working for Sony. And they had been building this big database, and how did it work? In a way, it was like a sampler, but if you wanted to play a piece of music, instead of playing that music, it found little fragments of the music in the database, and it played it using those fragments. So the example they played me was Janis Joplin singing Mercedes-Benz, this a cappella thing she sang, but it was all played with Beatles sounds. So it still sounded like Janis Joplin singing, but it was all Beatles sounds that were making this thing. And it was just this little robot that tended to, in the same way that you see those pictures that are made up of all the little pictures. That guy, I did this lecture at, what's it called? Caltech, the Media Lab. That wasn't Caltech, it's the one that's hooked up to, the one that's in Boston.
MIT.
I did a lecture at MIT. And you run into all sorts of weird people at MIT. So I get on the elevator, and this kid that looks like a first-year undergraduate, he wants to show me this thing on his computer. And it was that thing, the stuff. And he says, I've started this company. I've even got a building down the street. And this is going to be, everything's got, all photographs in the future are going to be like this. And I think he had his first Time cover like 3 weeks later or something. Funny place on MIT. The reference thing is something that obviously I've paid attention to and concentrated on. It's not the only thing, it's not the main thing. And that's probably one way of avoiding the real crux of your question, which was the end part, which I've forgotten now.
I think I've forgotten too, but you think about the process, or like, I don't know, it was a sort of open-ended.
It was also about from scratch.
Oh yeah, the scratch part. I think I did answer the scratch part. I was in a band in the 60s called The Grebs, in which I played my unamplified electric guitar that nobody could hear, and a record player. And we did some kind of scratch things, although I kind of like playing the records backwards by hand more than that. And we tried to do Beach Boys songs. There were two bongo players. They each had their own double bongos. They didn't share bongos, a bongo set. And a trumpet player and me playing records and inaudible guitar. So it was a pretty odd band. Did I say that we did Beach Boys and Dave Clark Five songs?
Yes, I did.
That was our specialty. any other comments before I suggest once again that we bring this to a close? Okay. Going once, going twice.
Brian Eno?
Let's go here.
You worked with Brian Eno at all?
We had adjacent rooms at this place called the Hayward Gallery in London, England. And he didn't want to come along when we went for the ride in the big Ferris wheel, so we didn't really get to talk very much.
Bummer.
That's it.
This is
25.
Oh, I see.
But somebody got paid to revise, and that was some of the funding. Well, they went to the library.